Today we are going to visit a very non-touristy place, the city of Severodvinsk, which is the center of the nuclear shipbuilding industry in Russia. It's located 30 kilometers west of the city of Arkhangelsk. Severodvinsk is a relatively young city. It was founded only in 1936, after the Soviet government decided to build a shipyard here. Severodvinsk developed rapidly, and the city's population grew because of the arrival of specialists from all over the Soviet Union. To maintain secrecy, Severodvinsk became a closed city. Wide streets and squares, boulevards and parks testify to the fact that the authorities have made significant efforts to make the city comfortable and modern for residents who work at strategic enterprises. But the Soviet Union collapsed. In the 1990s, the city experienced a severe decline and economic depression. Nevertheless, the local city forming enterprises associated with the production, repair and testing of submarines survived. But people still continue to live in the city, even in the present day. At present, the city of Severodvinsk is harsh and totally lacking in all glitz and glamour. The streets are not crowded, which is typical for closed city. The first impression is that the city is stuck somewhere between the 1980s and 1990s. I found it interesting that on every building in the city center you can see a sign with a letter that shows the energy efficiency class. This is the first city in which I have seen such signs. As I wandered the streets of the city, I didn't come across any international fast food chains, although they are somewhere according to the map. I wanted to go to the White Sea waterfront, but it wasn't easy. I met a military sailor and asked him how I could get to the sea. He said there was no way, as there were military factories all on the shore.
Так не пройти.
Я
не
думал, что набережная есть.
Набережная есть на Ядрах, да. Это вам нужно на Ядре поехать. Там набережная есть, можете. Это возле Никольского посада ездит автобус. Вот оттуда вам.
Спасибо.
15 номер автобуса.
Спасибо.
And to get to the seashore, I had to go to the neighborhood of Yagory, located on the island. So I went to the bus stop to catch a bus that would take me to the Yagory neighborhood. The neighborhood of Yagory is located on an island, which is connected to the mainland by a bridge. In Soviet times there was a labor camp here. The labor of the camp's prisoners was used to build a port, factories, roads and houses in the city. Now it's a typical bedroom community in the city. I walked along the deserted beaches and the promenade. The seawater had a faint mauve hue. It was windy. Waves were crashing down on the sandy shore, forming foam. High-rise buildings towered over the beach, adding to the surreal scene. After the walk, I took the bus back to the city of Arkhangelsk.